wiring are 110 volt AC system. And so what we had originally was all the wires going in the same area. But what we decided to do, just to prevent any sort of interference that could happen with having high voltage and different voltage wires running parallel, is that one might start sort of interfering with the other. So we lower our 110, 120 system on the bottom. So we'll have the 110 coming from this direction, and then we'll have the 12 coming from here. And then we're also gonna use a divider here, a barrier that they advise, a PVC barrier that goes in here just to split the two circuits.
So because we didn't put a 2x2 for our walls, the staple are kind of too wide and it just break our wood. So we decided to put those nylon cable clamp assortment that is not too tight. And I screw it in the bottom and then I just pass my wire inside. I'm now installing the 120 outlets. We've been running our wire in circuit, which means from the breaker box, it's gonna go to the first outlet, and then there is another wire from the first outlet to the second outlet, and then from the second to the third. We won't do more than three outlets in the same circuit because we feel safer this way. So the first outlet of the circuit is a GFCI outlet, which adds a little bit of protection. And then we go with this one, which also have a USB charger inside. There is a penury of building material.
A what?
A lack of construction product. So even to find switches is a little bit difficult.
We ordered these not on Amazon. We actually ordered it on Ace. I got the voltage dividing plates from SpaceX. Outside bus lights.
And we are about to set up our back camera to be able to see what we are doing when we back off, back away.
Yes.
Here's a camera with this black wire. So we just connected it to the big part. We got over there.
We need a double-headed female connector.
Wow!
The deal is you are gonna make a ground connection with the black, and with the red, you will connect it to the reverse lamp. Positive. This one. You know, if you look at this number over here, you can find it here and make the connection to it.
With our connection here, so I took the number of our reverse light, which is this one, and I follow the cable. And then I put a T connector with my wire from the camera. I kind of fold it inside like this. Like that, I was able to make it fit. And then with this one, I ground it to the bus frame.
I am putting in the screen, the backup screen. So when you back up, you know what you're hitting. I have to get the tamper-proof bit so I could unscrew this. Yeah, this one.
Okay.
I think a lot of this is from the old video thing that we don't have, so.
La la la.
Here's color. What does what? Make sure that you or the professional are using our original connector in your first installation. Otherwise, it could cause a short circuit.
Circus is in the air.
So I just finished cleaning all the cables here. There was a bunch that we didn't need. And now I'm getting ready to do the install of our monitor. We already know that it works. I haven't really matched like all these cables and stuff. So we're gonna put it here. And over here before there was a tape deck that came with the bus. And luckily, when we got the bus, it had the manual. I found the wire color codes. I went ahead and made labels. And I'm gonna find the wires here. And I'm gonna wire our monitor and match these with these according to the colors.
Trying it with a bus battery. What happened when you want to do a schoolie? You go back to
the school
of life. Because you need to know a little bit of everything. You need to know about demolition, about build, about electricity, about plumbing, about woodworking, metalworking, interior design, and patience.
Okay, here we go.
The positive. Connecting this to the battery ground.
See? After this.
We need to cut wires to make it work properly. And if you read the manual, it says to cut one loop, and if you read the website, it says to cut another loop. And if you read it in broken Chinese English, it says to keep the loop. So
We're just gonna go with the Amazon one with the pictures on it. So I'm gonna cut the purple loop.
So what's the deal?
I don't know. It says cut the purple loop if that's how you placed it.
Okay. So Carlos have been working all night with a camera, and here is the result.
This one's upside down. We have to cut a cable.
Well, I know it's the purple one.
If not. Boom! I wired everything from the back to the front. All the cameras are connected to the DVR over here. The DVR is also 12 volt. It's all nice and neat in there. So these are all the cameras back here. There's 8 channels. Right now I'm using a VGA to connect it to the monitor. You can do HDMI. Here's the network. These are all this is the power for all the cameras right now. This is for when we actually use the battery. I'm not using it yet. These, you see, has like a network cable in the back because it wants to plug into a network and to the internet. And then if you want to use the app on the phone, you have to get on the internet and then do the programming and install it according to the instructions. So I did that at home. And then what I did, so we can look at our cameras through our phone whenever we're away, is I bought this router, and then I bought this little dongle thing that I saw on Amazon for like $26, and this one connects to the hotspot, which would be my phone, and then this one goes to the connects to the internet plug in the router, and then the DVR connects to the router back here. Once I figured that out, which was a mission, then I was able to install the app and do what it asked me to do. And now we can actually see it through our phone. DVR. The DVR already has a hard drive inside, so to record the video as it happens. So we have cameras. So the cameras all go to the DVR, they connect back here, so.
Are they all separated or are they all?
They're all separated, but I'm not gonna draw like a line for it. And then you wanna see what's going on in the camera, so you connect the monitor so you can see what's going on. The DVR will give you options. And then you want to be able to see it from your phone. So what you do is you also have a connection here to a router. And then this router is connected to the internet. So the internet here, and then the DVR connects to the router. And then over here, when you connect with your phone, once you download the app, you connect to the internet, and you can find your device, and then you can see each channel. Yeah, everything is 12 volts.